She has brought us some of the biggest news stories from home and around the globe, and she's someone you've trusted in your homes every single night, and she's a colleague that we are all proud to work alongside. It's now time for Sandra Sully to be the news story. The legendary 10 News First presenter is celebrating 30 years, can you believe, at Network 10, and we are so thrilled to have her on our humble little show. Please welcome Sandra Sully. Yay!
Thank you, everyone.
Very sweet of you all. Wow.
I'm feeling
really
old.
Have you?
No.
Oh, my God. Well, first things first, you look amazing.
Yeah, thank you. That's for the hair and makeup team who always keep me together in wardrobe.
It's such an amazing milestone, though. I mean, 30 years, you are such a trailblazer. And to start at a time when it was mostly blokes on the telly. And reading news bulletins, and you would hear so many male voices, and now it's your voice and your face we see.
Look, I mean, people know I stumbled into television and news and journalism. It's not anything I ever had dreams of becoming. I ended up, you know, got a job in a TV station and switched degrees and got a cadetship. But I fell in love with news and clearly loved journalism. But I used to say, I just want a career in news. And Yarn Event was, you know, current affairs queen and the queen of Australian television. The natural road was news and then current affairs. And I said, but I love news. And they said, you won't have a career in news. It's a man's world. And fortunately, you know, we managed to change things a little bit.
Well, I remember, I think I was there at the start when you came to Channel 10. I was already at 10.
You were, Kak. Yeah, you were, absolutely. Yeah, I started in the Canberra Bureau at Federal Parliament, and I was just such a cub reporter and so green, and I was snatched from a regional Canberra station. I think I came without travel expenses and removal costs, so they got me cheap.
Welcome to...
Yeah, well, welcome to TV. And I was so nervous and a hopeless young cub reporter, worried sick about the stories I was meant to be reporting on. And the first yarn I got sent out on was to cover the Prime Minister's 11 at Manuka Oval. Really? So I had to do a cricket story. Thank goodness I had an amazing producer who helped me write a cricket story because I wasn't expecting to do that. But the plus was that, you know, Imran Khan was in the team and he was very flirtatious.
Good evening. Wow. I'm Sandra Sully.
Now, oh, come on, guys. Do you remember Imran Khan?
Oh, I do.
Yeah, we do.
Oh,
we do.
I believe he's currently the Prime Minister of Pakistan. But, yeah, I don't know what else he's ever done. So what was the highlight for you? What is the thing that you remember really stands out in your time here at 10?
Well, from a journalism perspective, clearly September 11, but... Look, I think a lot of people in TV and in journalism have been in the game a long time. You know, Steve Quatermain, our colleague in Melbourne, been at the network longer than I. But to be at the one place is the most special part about it because we are a family. I'm really proud of the career I've ended up in journalism. We do important work. You know, we hold politicians and institutions to account with the checks and balances on a strong, healthy democracy. But we also... look at the bushfires, save lives by imparting important information that was critical to saving communities and people. That's amazing. But every night I stand on the shoulders of the efforts of the team around me, and how lucky am I and proud every night, because we used to punch above our weight because we've been through some hard times. Now we match it day for day, minute for minute, hour by hour. And it gets me emotional because, well, think of the bushfires and what it's like on the road. And, you know, all of Australia knew what that was like. Mm. But that's what makes what we do so wonderful, because as a team, we're out there in the trenches doing that, and it galvanises you in the most special way. Mm. So for me, my tribe is journalism, my family is 10.
Mm. I have to do have to take you back to that evening when 9/11 occurred. Now, for many of us, me included, I was a colleague of yours at the time, but at that particular time I was home watching the television, as were so many other Australians. You brought us what is to this day one of the most devastating news stories of all time. And you brought it to us in such a way that we could somehow start wrapping our heads around something that was unbelievable in every way. When did you get a moment to wrap your head around what was actually happening?
Well, at the instant I saw the vision of what we were told was a plane had hit the World Trade Center, everyone thought it was a light plane. As soon as I saw that vision, I knew it was a jetliner. It's not a mistake. Then the second goes in. I was galvanised to the seat. I felt this imaginary seatbelt just strap me in and weigh me down to the chair. And all I was, and the world changed in an instant. It's never been the same. Thank you. And I thought I was watching, you know, World War III unfold. Mm. It was so monumental. But what was overwhelming was trying to get the tone right. It wasn't about keeping people watching me on 10. I needed to say to everybody watching, don't turn off your televisions. This is history unfolding as we speak. The world will never be the same again. And it hasn't.
Because you were the first on the network that night.
Yeah.
And I remember...
It was late news. Doing,
yes, late news. And you just kept going with zero information. Well, very little information, because there wasn't a lot coming out of America.
And, the world froze.
Yeah, and technology was not the same. You know, there wasn't Twitter. There wasn't any of that stuff in these days. So you literally made it up as you went along. Yeah.
Well, there was only CNN those days in terms of a cable broadcaster, so I was getting their feed in my ear. But those American broadcasters, and full credit to them, they were gobsmacked, groping and grappling for the right way to describe it. They were also dumbstruck that it was happening to them. Mm. So they refused to call it terrorism. I had the benefit of some degree of perspective and distance to say this is at the financial heart of the world. So all of that was, you know, extraordinary. And
the ramifications of that as well, yeah.
Well, and, you know, Australians, up until September 11, we lived in the beautiful bubble of the Southern Hemisphere and we could enjoy the disconnect of the global village, but that night all Australians became global citizens. Mm. And that night we knew international affairs affected us every day.
Cactus touched on technology and how that's changed as well over the years. I'm sure when you started as a cub reporter, as you say, you had the old walkie-talkies in the back of the car. You are huge on Twitter. You love tweeting and presenting the bulletin. You've always got something going on. And what I love about you as well, Sulz, is that if someone throws something at you...
Fair bit of shade, you mean?
Throw it back. And I think it's, as a woman as well, working in the television news game, so much is made of how we look and what we wear. How do you deal with that?
Well, I mostly laugh. I accepted early on when, you know, you used to take it very personally when you're, when you're young in any game, and I encourage people to just try and be able to laugh at yourself. And I've accepted that I don't. Not everyone likes me, and they don't like what I'm wearing yesterday.
How could anyone not like you? It's outrageous. Who was the name?
Yesterday, it was like, well, you stop wearing granny dresses, and what you're wearing looks like a bib. And I just like the comment because I don't expect you to acknowledge it. And it's like you're entitled to your view, and it's okay.
You have had amazing hairstyles over the years, which is why the crew at Team Daily, they knew you were on board when they made this great app that you can use, and you can find out which Sandra Sully you are compared, you know, depending on the hairstyle that you've had.
Oh, like this.
We all took the test.
I'm 2010
as well.
Sandra Sully.
Where was I a redhead? That's what I want to know.
Oh, here we go.
Well,
what
bitch,
am
what
I?
What are you going to be?
2003.
I'm a two-time.
Hey, look at this.
Come on, Cac.
Oh,
I think that was the Logies.
Oh, yep.
That was a Logies, too.
I think I've asked for the Sandra on a few occasions at the hairdressers.
That's the news reading Bob.
What have we got, Tash?
Yeah. Hey! Oh, that was mine too, Tash. 2013, one of my more favourite do's it was, actually.
A bit
channeling a bit of Jennifer Aniston, trying
to... Yeah, a bit of the Rachel.
Well, I leave it to the guys downstairs to come up with something, and you look and think, oh, cool, thanks.
Yeah. But I love that you're part of that little bit of technology, that app, because you've always embraced the new technology. Like Sarah said, you're straight onto Twitter. Now you've got your own podcast too, Black.
I do. Elevating, inspiring Australian women, not necessarily celebrities, but we call it Short Black, Good Women, Great Chat. And it's just about shining a light on women doing interesting, remarkable things, not necessarily celebrities.
And you're leaving, well, you've got quite a legacy in your wake as well. You have a fabulous scholarship that's just been announced. Can you tell us about that quickly?
Really proud to reveal, and the applications are now open. And I just wanted to pay my good fortune forward. I love journalism, and I'm sick of hearing about the demise of journalism. You know, we value quality journalism, and it's an amazing ride, and I wanted to pay it forward by giving an opportunity to a current or enrolling student at the University of Western Sydney to help them. It costs so much to study. We can make a difference and change someone's life, and someone else gets to enjoy the ride and contribute and give back, then, you know, how lucky are we? And I want to thank the network for agreeing to do that
for the money. Yeah. And UWS, great institution as well.
Yes, exactly. And they're celebrating 30 years.
They are,
so I thought the synergy was amazing.
Oh, natural.
Yeah, it was a great fit.
And along with that, which is a great legacy, congratulations with all the work over several years as patron for Spinal Cure.
Thank you, Kat. Can I just tell a very silly story?
Yes.
But, you know, when you were finishing on Good Morning Australia and I got the tap on the shoulder on the Friday afternoon ahead of the Monday launch, and I said, oh, I've never done live television. They said, sorry, just pop in Monday morning, a couple of hours of live TV. I was green as, and I said, well, what am I going to wear? They said, just go into CAC's dressing room and bop and borrow a jacket. I said, I can't wear sequins in the morning.
Of course you can. Sandra, congratulations on 30 stellar years. Here's to many, many, many more. This is why you are the queen of the TV screen. We love you. You can, of course, catch Sandra at 5 o'clock weeknights on 10 News First in Sydney.
Sandra, as we say here on... I know you're prime time, but as we say on morning television, here's one we prepared earlier.
Sandra Sully, everyone.